Hi, this is Matt Bergman, and you're listening to the Punk Rock Libertarians podcast, episode 94. I'm here tonight with Jared Schneiderman.
Hey, guys.
And Logan Dahl.
Hey, hey, hey.
And Josh Stavlofagus.
How's it going?
And Philip Proctor.
Yes.
Hello. Hey, before we go, Josh, I'm always
curious. We're not going.
Oh. Sorry. Uh-oh. How do you actually say your last name?
Yeah. Stavrakoglu.
Nope.
Stavrakoglu.
Right, Stav. My.
That name's a fucking nightmare. Yeah. Matt, you're right.
Yes, dear. Whatever agency is actually possibly looking at this. No, I don't. It's pronounced Stavrakoglu. My last name is phonetic. You can break it up into syllables. There's
what
no hidden pronunciation.
All right, now on to something interesting.
Yeah, I really don't. Yeah, it's not interesting to me. All
right.
Yeah. So. Did anybody catch Meryl Streep's speech this week going the Golden Globes?
I think it was like last-ish week, but
whatever, dude.
Whatever.
Yeah. No, I didn't. But really? I heard about it. Did anyone actually watch the whole thing?
I didn't watch it. That's part of it. They played it on the morning show on the radio station on my way to work and stuff, so I heard it there.
Yeah. She basically... Like, she ragged on Trump for mimicking a mentally retarded person... But, you know, this is a lady who's always, like, jacked President Obama, who's, you know, been bombing everybody for 8 years, you know?
Yeah.
I believe it's, like, one bomb every 20 minutes for this administration, over 26,000 bombs.
Yeah. That's fucking sick. I saw people also pointed out that she, I guess, like, what, 10, 15 years ago, stood up and clapped for Roman Polanski, who was, like, a known, like,
pedophile.
Yeah.
Was he known at the time?
Yes.
Yeah, dude.
Roman Polanski's been a director for like
he was known
yeah,
years.
When did this happen? Does anybody know?
That thing happened. I think it was the
ago.
'90s.
I'm not,
was
I'm not familiar wasn't with
it?
At all.
It's older than that.
I'm really? Was it?
Yeah.
I think that was in the '80s.
So it was like 30 years ago.
'70s or '80s.
Yeah. I mean, it was before Gladiator.
It might have been in the '70s.
Yeah.
Roman Polanski, Gladiator.
Gladiator.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. Yeah, that's an interesting hypocrisy. And I mean, dude, I honestly, like, I've watched that video several times of Trump, like, doing the hand gesture thing, but I don't know that he's literally mocking that single reporter.
Yeah, I mean, I saw clips. Somebody made a clips of defending him in his little gesture.
Yeah,
saying he does that all the time.
Right.
Yeah, but that's a kind of commonly known like making fun of a disabled person. That's
right.
Like,
yeah.
That's I mean, not to say that that's something a president should be doing. I'm not saying that, but
I mean, but
to be fair,
if anything, someone should admire the fact that Trump would have to dig so much as to find out that maybe, you know, that the author of said article that was written that made him upset was actually disabled. That required real, like, you know, digging. That was an effort. That might be the first
time
a president might have put effort into doing anything.
He didn't do it, though.
But that's what
one
I'm
of
saying.
His
like the
advisors or something.
I would argue that he wouldn't have like the cognizance to go and dig that deep. And I don't think there's any evidence that he actually knew the guy.
Yeah.
So I mean, I don't know. Like it's splitting hairs, but at the same time, you know, if Meryl Streep's going to make that like a centerpiece of her little diatribe on Trump, it's like, well, it
is. It mean
you kind of got to look into it. Was
what he did in poor taste? Yeah, sure, fine. You can make that argument. Do I care whether he says it or not? No, I don't. I can think anything he can say could be the most offensive thing I could ever hear in my life. I still think he should be allowed to say it. He just has to.
Sure.
The court of public opinion is what's going to convict him anyway.
Yeah, well, I mean, I look at it like this. Like at this point, you know, Trump hasn't even been put into office. And like the current administration's done so much fucked up shit. You know, the prior administration did so much fucked up shit. And I mean, from what I've seen in my life was like each dude is worse, you know. Each president is worse. Like they take the ways that you know, the last guy pushed the envelope and they only use that to then push it further.
Mm.
So, I mean, like for me, it's like right now, you know, Trump hasn't done shit. But, you know, Obama was pretty fucking bad, and these people weren't saying anything.
Let me ask you something. I guess I'll hold that question for later because it's going to be a later topic.
Okay.
Well,
Sorry.
I mean, I'm someone who's just who's going to be more concerned with someone's policies and actual actions as it affects policy than, you know, getting upset about. Yeah, I mean, the guy's a boorish douchebag, like, whatever, but if he doesn't drop, if he drops only half the bombs that Obama dropped, he'll be that much better than Obama, you know, if he...
Yeah, well, here's the thing, too, that people forget, is that the rest of the world knows that he's absolutely fucking insane, and that everyone that's sane here knows that he's absolutely fucking insane, but the fact that he's so dumb, I don't think anything he's going to do is going to make that much of a difference either way. And the rest of the world and us can just sit there and watch and know we're all going to be fine because we know this is like this is the dumbest thing in the world.
Since we're kind of talking about it, do you think that if Trump gets elected, he'll be he'll drop just as many or less bombs?
He's been elected though.
What did I say? If he gets elected,
call me a fucking stoner.
When he takes office, rather, is what I mean.
His warmongering advisors.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what I'm worried about.
I'm Mattis. Same hell here, no. I'm all about that, man. Fucking Mad Dog Mattis.
We're probably gonna have fun with you for the next few years.
He's advising him on military, what the military does, not whether to.
Yeah, he's not the Secretary of State.
Yeah, he's not deciding.
You know what though? But when it, you have to think that you have
we know that you have a hard on for fucking Mattis.
No, but you have to think about something. If you have to make the decision whether you're going to go to war or not, and you have the I don't know, a 4-star general sitting there at your disposal who's known to be very, very logical when it comes to actually having to use force. And you're...
It's not a bad thing.
It's a good thing.
But that's not one voice.
So, he changed Trump's entire stance on waterboarding in a half-hour meeting.
I believe it was torture in general, actually.
Well, that's waterboarding, not my, most specifically, because that was what everybody says. When they say waterboarding, they pretty much mean other methods of torture. But waterboarding is the only thing anybody who watches mainstream media even fucking knows.
That wasn't my question, though. My question is, do you think that he's going to be, like, as many bombs and shit are going to get dropped on these foreign countries?
No, because you know what, though, Matt?
Do you think in relate, like,
no, you
following
might, you,
that?
If wars start, you're going to see... It's not going to be as many bombs, but you know what? If we ever have to get into a conflict, whoever it is better be fucking ready.
Yeah,
because if
Mattis
has anything to do with it, everyone is going to be crushed.
What I'm saying is the theory about a lot of the things we get today, like ISIS and the terrorist attacks, are caused by our own doing, such as the bombs that we're dropping on these people's, like their homes, and they're creating these radicals. Do you think we're going to see kind of like a drop in that type of thing if there's going to be less bombs dropped
in radical Islam, you mean?
If our foreign policy changes a little bit and becomes a little less concerned with, you know, the Middle East as far as getting involved in everybody's shit, as in dropping bombs, giving money to countries who are known to stir up fucking trouble or be shitty regimes, I think we'd be fine. I think we'd be better off than we have.
Well,
in
I don't
the
know
past.
That we would be fine. I mean, you've already created the monster. Like, ISIS isn't just going to stop trying to establish the caliphate because we stopped dropping bombs.
But we can still stop, and then
we can
have a strong defense.
Yeah, we can have a strong defense, and we can stop radicalizing people and getting them to join ISIS.
Yeah, I think that would be a great.
ISIS is already there. That needs to be dealt with somehow. But as far as just bombing innocent people.
What they really should do is they should give the military the tools they need to actually finish the fucking job, because they don't give them. I really don't think they give. When I was deployed,
what do you mean they don't have enough bombs?
I don't think we have. You know, the military has enough tools at their disposal. Or
we need
at least
four more drones.
What do you mean by tools? Because I mean we spend more money on our military than anybody else.
Yes, I understand that. But you don't think some of these things are made? Some of these tools are made to substandard, to substandards, just to be able to create more reason to generate more money to stay at war longer because we can't finish the job. If they fucking lifted the rules of fucking engagement that we have over there, to stop with this fucking Geneva Convention bullshit and just take these motherfuckers out, wherever they are.
Dude, the Geneva Convention is there to prevent war crimes and genocide, you dumbass.
Dude, I don't know.
We kill more innocents that way.
Yeah. No. If you know, because there's the rules of engagement is like if you could practically see somebody you know is going to commit a crime in front of you, you know this person is headed to go do that. You know, based on intelligence, but until they do something that engages you, unless it's a mission that's higher up,
dude,
taking out a target's not exactly something that happens often.
Didn't intelligence tell us that we had WMDs?
What?
Like, didn't intelligence tell us that we had WMDs?
No.
What is that? How's that related?
Intelligence.
Well, I'm just saying, like, you supposedly know somebody is going to commit a crime because of intelligence.
So basically what he's saying is there was
there's no WMD.
He's trying to insinuate that if someone walks up to you with an AK and they don't shoot at you, you don't get to shoot back? Is that the...
For lack of a better term.
I mean, you don't think people should be allowed to own guns?
Fuck you, man.
No, I mean, like, which one of these countries do you think we ought to be in?
We shouldn't be in any of them.
Well, yeah, so I think that's like the number one fucking thing.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is shit. Take shit or get off the pot. You know, either give the military the right tools to fucking do the goddamn bullshit job that we shouldn't be doing in the first place, or pull us out completely. Stop keeping people there, not giving them the things they need to finish the job, and just playing with their lives and just mediocre sense of just I don't know, like plateau. Because nothing's happening. Why is Guantanamo Bay still fucking there?
You know, if we were in a legitimate war, and by legitimate, I mean, like, you know, somebody...
Congressionally declared war?
No, well, I mean, not even Congress. How are they legitimate? So I'm talking, like, if we were in a legitimate war, legitimately just war, that would be where somebody hit us first. And, yes. You know what I'm saying? And I don't think we can say that about any of these wars that we're in.
I understand that.
So, I mean, it's like...
Yeah, I think you're completely missing the point.
Until we're in a legitimate war, I mean...
But I think you're completely missing the point. Is that people, I mean, either stop playing with people's lives, and because these wars are only helping to sustain the companies that are involved, the contracting that's involved. So either give the military the tools to finish the job and stop just leaving this plain old sense of nothing's getting done to just make more money, be over there longer... That's all that is. It's to generate contracts.
Yeah, but I mean, it's like finish the job, though. I mean, the job shouldn't exist.
Yes, I understand that. But pick one or the other.
Well, just pick one.
Whoever is in office.
I just want to pick, like, the morally just one, dude. Yeah. Dude, I'm serious.
Triggered.
It's end the fucking war.
I would like that to fucking happen, but I don't see that happening.
You're basically saying like. Well, I mean, if you're going to go and be a serial killer, at least have the right tools to...
If you're saying, hey, you know what, we're going to take out ISIS, then let us actually be able to take out ISIS. Because there are ways that obviously I think are going to cause a little more damage.
We've barely been engaging with ISIS.
Too busy bombing hospitals and weddings.
So that's why we should either end it or... Just fucking destroy everything. Pick one at this point.
Okay. I think we get it.
End everything.
All right.
Shit's getting old, man.
Switching gears.
Yeah, dude.
All right. Do you have something to say, Bourbon?
No. Bourbon? I'm just saying no more ore.
No more ore.
Yeah. We could do the right thing, or...
It's just getting old, dude.
But...
What's getting old?
The right thing.
Like,
talking about the right thing, dude.
No, I'm saying the whole Iraq war thing.
Doing the right
old.
Thing.
Somebody needs to just fucking call it.
Yeah,
call
end
it.
Retarded.
Obama said he got us out of war.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I thought so. I know plenty of people still over there.
So what about Trump's
fake news?
Well, when he had his first press conference since being
such a let's back up.
Such a dumbass.
So. Prior to that press conference that you were about to talk about, some news broke that alleged that Trump had been paying, and this has happened years ago. I don't remember the exact year that it was alleged, but he was basically paying some hookers to pee, not pee on him, but to pee on each other.
Was R. Kelly there?
Yeah. He was doing the peeing. In a hotel. And so this news came out, and it was apparently attached to some sort of Russian intelligence dossier. And so basically, apparently this had been out for a long time, but no news media wanted to touch it because there just wasn't enough evidence for it. But of course, BuzzFeed got their hands on it. And they don't give a fuck about evidence or anything.
Fucking BuzzFeed.
So they posted it, and then it was discovered. So as soon as they posted it, every news media started talking about it. So then it came out like later that day that apparently it was a story that was completely fabricated that came from 4chan, and there was nothing real about it. And like CNN posted it, and you know, all sorts of mainstream media. I think it was mainly CNN that was the first major news media besides from BuzzFeed to break it. And so then, later that day, I believe, or it was the next day, Trump gave his first press conference, and a CNN reporter was trying to ask him a question. And he just kept saying, nope, nope, not you, not you, not you.
I watched it over and over and over again.
He can go, nope, not you, not you. And then he's like,
don't be rude, don't be rude.
Don't be rude.
No, no, not you.
He's like,
no.
Caught him fake.
And then he was like, your organization is terrible. CNN is fake news. Yeah.
Dude, your organization is terrible. You're trash.
It was probably the greatest thing that Trump has ever said in his whole life.
I agree. But here's the thing. They're all fucking fake news.
I mean, look.
I mean, to a degree. Yeah.
I mean, at this point, I guess you can, since we're talking about Trump, you know, and how he treats everything like it's a TV show. I mean, we can talk about the last one over there real quick.
What?
Steve
Harvey.
Why
are you derailing this?
I don't know. You want to switch and go and
sabotage?
We barely talked about this topic, dude.
I mean, you said to an extent that most of these news stations are fake news, but I'm to the point where I'm convinced it's all fucking fake. Like,
define fake news.
I mean, yeah. Well,
they're agenda driven.
It's all bullshit. Basically,
fake news. The term fake news, which is hilarious to me, basically has no meaning anymore. But it was originally created by the left to smear any sort of right-wing or conservative or libertarian media and, you know, saying
anything that wasn't liberal, you know, for that matter.
I mean, dude, the term fake news is so fucking awesome, dude, because it fucking backfired.
That's
on
what
them,
I'm
okay?
saying, dude. That's what I'm saying. Like, that's the beauty of it is, like, the left came up with this term.
Yeah, it seems like Barry was the first person to talk about it, correct?
Barry?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah, he was like, oh, I'm going to crack down on fake news or something like that.
Yeah, and he's a real sack of shit.
And then, like, some college came up with, like, a bogus list, some college professor. And, you know, now, though, it's like everybody's calling out the fake news. It's just fucking awesome. I don't know. I think it's just fucking amazing. I love how it backfired on them.
Also, everything is also now alt-right. Anything is alt-right. That's another. I love how fake news and alt-right have become the new buzzwords.
Well, you know, I think before, if you would have said fake news, people would be like, conspiracy theorist. But now it's like more people than ever are admitting that there's fake news. It's like, you know, it's like the establishment has admitted that there is. So it's like, you know, now people are just like questioning everything.
Exactly.
Well, yeah, but here's
at
the
least
thing.
More
still,
so than before.
Anybody that's your average Joe is, if you question anything, they're raised and hardwired from the time they're born to that everything's a certain way, and anybody that questions that, they're a conspiracy theorist or they're fucking nuts. I mean, that's what happens. I get it every day. It's fucking, it's bullshit.
Well, I mean, what people need to realize is, I mean, every piece of news and every news source is to some degree biased. But the best sources, I think, are the ones that are honest about that bias.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, the Free Thought Project. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely super biased. It's super, like, anti-government. It's super, like, anti... they're kind of, like, anti... I guess you'd say anti-cop or whatever, but...
I feel like they're just anti, you know...
Yeah, I mean, they're anti-establishment. But it's like, they may take a story and sort of... you know, give it from a certain perspective.
Well, I mean, you know, I'd say they're anti the initiation of force, and I'm sure they're biased, but I mean, I like their bias, and it's because of their bias
I
go there so often.
That's what I'm saying, though. But they're upfront with their bias,
absolutely. Yeah.
And even, you know, somebody
like, it's kind of like they're reporting the news in kind of like the way I would look at it.
Right. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. So I mean. It's not fake news, is it?
Is
like
that, is I'm sorry, usually, but is Free Thought ran by libertarians or
Yes.
Yeah, I thought so.
Yeah, but do you notice when you read the articles, even when they present, you know, not say they're an opinion, but you know, they move the conversation in a certain direction. The difference with the free thought articles is most of it makes me question things a little more, rather than come up with a conclusion on my own. You know, like I didn't read this conclusion, you know, within their articles. I'm asking myself more questions.
Yeah,
that's what I find with their articles, and that's what I look for in articles that I read when it comes to politics. I'm not looking for necessarily just their perspective. I'm looking for them to make me challenge it.
But the thing is that they do that. You know, like you read it, and it's like they'll throw in little things like this, like, you know, road pirate. They'll use like language that we would use talking on this show, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so they are definitely speaking to a certain audience. But so is every other major news source. But the thing is, they don't admit it. They won't admit that they're talking to the left. No. Or well,
they have no affiliation. They literally politically unaffiliated. They're governmentally
unaffiliated, though. That's the thing. Yeah, exactly. They are affiliated. Yeah, and the same thing goes for like Fox News, although
they
seem to be a little more open to the fact that they're conservative.
Yeah, but you know what? I was talking to a buddy about this the other day at work. And, you know, he was just like ragging on Fox News because he said that they were biased. And I'm like, well, you know, yeah, okay, so they're biased to the right, but every other news source, major news source like ABC, NBC, CBS, CNN, so forth, they're all biased to, you know, the Democratic Party. They're biased to the, you know, the bullshit American left, you know? Yeah. And he's like, no. And I'm like, actually, dude, do you honestly think if you took a poll from these people that they wouldn't, like, you know, 98% of them probably be voting for, or that's probably a generous estimate, would have been voting for Hillary, you know, supported Obama, you know, you know, they're harder on, there's obviously a bias there. The thing is, like, those stations aren't as obvious about it as Fox News. But when you think about it, isn't it kind of like, you know, it's kind of more respectable that, you
that's
know,
what
that
yeah.
Fox News is straight up about it. And these other stations are, like, bullshitting you.
To not do it
saying
is,
that they're
is
not
deceptive,
biased.
Yeah. To not do it is entirely deceptive because then, you know, if people aren't necessarily, like, you know, true blue Democrats, they're going to watch this news, you know, growing up or whatever, and just think that, whoa, this is just unbiased. Like, this is what's actually real. Like, there's no opinion in this. This is just the facts. I'm just getting the facts.
I think Fox is just a little more obviously right-leaning because there's just one of them. So they go harder right.
True. But then you have some like Breitbart, which is, like, even further to the right than Fox News is. But
they don't have a cable.
True.
You know,
yeah.
You know,
TV station.
You know what's kind of funny, though? If you look at Fox News and you look at what Fox TV programming and how completely opposite those two things
it
are.
It is kind of interesting. Like,
you know, the shows that they are responsible for, like, I mean, The Simpsons, which basically is, you know.
Yeah, like Married with Children.
Married with Children. Or Family Guy, which is.
Exactly, Family
Seth
Guy.
MacFarlane
Futurama.
Is like the biggest lefty out there.
Yeah.
I mean, look at all these shows that are completely not. They're anti-right.
Yeah,
they're very openly anti-right, and they're funny as hell. But
although I think I don't know if I call Futurama anti-right.
No. Futurama.
They make fun
of everybody. Futurama's just a great. Futurama's just fucking phenomenal.
Yeah.
But then you look at what the news puts out, and do you notice these same people
Futurama.
Are they're fueling something that's basically completely preaching against their own agenda. That's how ridiculous that is.
Yeah, it
is. They don't see that this is for fucking money. Half of these people, you know, Fox actually hires more liberals than they do Republicans.
Fox hires more.
More people working at Fox are liberal.
But there must be some sort of.
They're just savvy. They're playing to their audience.
Exactly.
Speaking of which, what's her name? Just not that it fucking
Kelly
matters,
Megan or Megan Kelly?
Yeah,
Megan Kelly. Megan.
Where's she going? And she's going to NBC, isn't she?
She did already, I think.
Yeah.
Well, that fucking sucks. Who really?
I mean, maybe she'll bring some conservative balance. There.
Balance to the force.
Well, I mean, she's not conservative. Didn't she vote for Hillary Clinton?
No.
Way. Are you serious? Did she vote for that?
I mean, she was...
Really?
She definitely didn't vote for Trump.
Yeah.
I think
she
probably
did. Who do you think she voted
think
for,
any chance
I think
she, that she voted
I think
Gary
she might have been a secret Johnson.
A secret
dude,
Johnson?
Dude, I think she
secret
wants Johnson.
Wow, dude.
She looks like she can
use she's
a
secret Johnson.
Johnson
vote.
Do you guys want to hear my Johnson secret?
Oh, my God.
No.
No, I'm good, brother.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe. Yeah, who knows? Yeah, I mean, I guess if she didn't vote for Trump.
I mean, she could have voted for anybody at this point. I mean, who cares?
You know, either way, that's the other thing. You know what?
I don't think she's a liberal.
I think I'm overvoting.
You're overvoting?
Yeah.
So you're going to vote more than once, or?
No, I'm done. I think I'm done doing it.
I think I'm overvoting.
Well, good for you, man. You've seen the light.
Yeah.
So that's the guy who voted this year.
Yeah. Did you?
Yeah. I mean, why not?
Yeah. I'm to the point now where I think everything's bullshit, and it's just control and.
So like
I don't believe that.
Like so you don't. So you're never gonna vote or what?
Probably not. I think.
What if Ron Paul's second coming?
Is this only presidential elections or is this local elections?
I think it's everything.
Because local elections, voting in local elections, that's what most people don't realize. Most of the people, millennials that are all pissed off that Hillary Clinton fucking lost, don't even realize that if we get involved locally.
Do not let me in with those people.
No,
there's
no.
A totally different reason for me just not voting.
No, I'm not you. Not you. I'm not saying you at all.
Dude, but what? Logan's got a Hillary Clinton bumper sticker on his car.
Does he? But I mean, there's
if there's a Hillary Clinton bumper sticker on my car right now, I'm gonna crash my car on the way.
I think it says I'm with her.
I can peel it off, but it's not gonna be the same effect.
It says I'm with herpes.
But dead serious, there's a whole group of people, and I really think they're the ones that are in their early 20s right now that don't realize if they get involved on a local level, they can change things more. Local level is where the whole thing starts. People don't realize that being like a grassroots actually means you have to be, you know, you have to do things locally too. That's where you make the most change is in your own community, and then things can ripple out.
Sure.
They don't want to do local, but then there are groups liberal groups that do that because they understand that.
Yeah, I'd say do whatever the fuck you want.
Yeah.
I would say vote locally. Locally is where it's the most important. I mean, voting for president, I mean, that's just voting for, okay, which dumbass do I want to see on TV? Box,
you can do both, basically.
What?
You can vote locally and you can do both because it's on the same ballot.
Exactly.
You literally just push the button right below that. Right? I mean, I guess if you're talking midterm elections, yeah, pay attention to those too. Yeah. No, you're right, though. I mean, you know, we keep wanting to have this one great hope, the fucking Luke Skywalker that's going to rise up and just, like, take down the two-party system.
It's never going to happen.
It's got to be a more grassroots, embedded process.
It has to start.
Or it has to be the Derek Rose, John Vibes thing and say, fucking, just...
Yeah, it's either that, or change like that's going to have to be an infection. It's going to have to start slow, and it's going to have to begin and...
It's got to be viral, like herpes.
Yeah. I think I'm basically transitioning
freedom,
from
herpes,
from libertarian
freedom bumps.
Hey, Philip, so where are you on voting?
Some freedom crabs from Maryland.
I vote pretty consistently.
How does that sound?
Yeah.
Like, who'd you vote for the last time, dude?
Gary Johnson.
Hell yeah. Cool.
Yeah. So you're all about that Johnson, huh?
I think I'm transitioning from from libertarian to full on like anarchist.
Uh-oh, dude.
I'm a voluntarist.
Oh, dude. There's no coming back from that.
I'm a voluntarist, man.
I don't think it's a bad thing.
It's not, but I'm just warning you, man. Once you go anarchist, you never go.
My roads.
My
roads.
Yeah, dude. As soon as you become anarchist,
my fucking roads.
They blow up the goddamn roads.
They come by with a jackhammer and just rip up your driveway.
We're taking back the roads. You don't pay for them no more.
That was the other thing, dude. Yeah. I got a ticket the other day. I was in the city.
So I'm so excited about this ticket.
No, I was so pissed off because I couldn't get up. I was,
dude. It was the hugest ticket.
I was sitting in on a tattoo session and fucking the guy's like, "Oh, the fucking meter fairy's coming through." And
dude, did you get a tattoo, dude?
I did.
Oh, what is it, dude?
Is it
a butterfly?
I wish it was a butterfly. It's an owl.
Above your taint?
It's an owl. It's a three-eyed owl.
A three-eyed owl?
Yeah.
Whoa, dude.
Yeah.
That looks pretty dope.
Dude, I've got a one-eyed
Wait, is that
creature.
The three-eyed owl from Game of Thrones?
No.
Wasn't there a three-eyed
owl? Was there one? I never got into Game of Thrones.
The third eye, man.
Why does it have the third eye, man?
No, I said it's a wise owl with a third eye.
Okay, so what is your tattoo like supposed to mean, dude?
Dude, is that the Illuminati eye up there?
Yeah, I mean, it's got a bunch of fucking. It's got the 13 arrows in there from the dollar, like on the back of the dollar bill. But like the third eye was like
lucky
the,
13.
Weed.
I think it's the colonies. Bro.
The colonies, yeah.
I know. Third eye basically weed. Just you know like represents kind of awakening and like seeing through all the fucking bullshit that goes on in the world, and it's got the pine cone back there that's like pine cone represents like the pineal gland which goes with the
third eye. Are you getting it colored in?
I think it's mostly gonna be shading. I don't
does that does the pine cone mean that, or is it like the pine cone from like Ice Age?
I seriously, that is the pine cone from Ice Age.
Pine cones.
But anyway, so I was sitting.
I have an owl. I actually have an owl on my arm as well.
Movie references that you don't know.
I was sitting in on that, and fucking, I was in the city, so the meter fairy was coming through, and I the max thing on the meter.
The
was,
meter fairy,
dude. What's a better word? What's a better word or better term? Meter fairy or road pirate?
Road pirate for sure.
I mean,
pirate sounds
saying, which
road
one is
pirate,
better, though?
No, road pirate sounds like something's like, dude, road I gave pirate. Her a Cincinnati road pirate. That doesn't sound like anything that you want to be called.
Like, well, yeah, they don't want to be called.
No,
that's
but
the fucking
point.
Yeah, dude, come on.
No, dude,
all right.
It's wasting a good reference. So don't waste a good reference on them.
The most you could put in was like $2 for 4 hours, like, was the max. And then I forgot about it because, I mean, I parked. It's not like I fucking did anything where I should have to pay.
Yeah.
So I get a fucking ticket.
Didn't you already pay for those
exactly.
roads?
Exactly. So I had a fucking ticket for fucking son of a bitch parking on the road that I fucking paid for.
Yeah.
So now I got to pay again. Although, well, I guess technically
dude, maybe
I
they heard you were going to be an anarchist. Yeah. Nate.
I guess technically I don't pay for those roads because I live in the county.
Roads.
Those are city roads.
So how much was the ticket?
$32, but it's still fucking bullshit.
Yeah.
$32, damn.
It's fucking revenue.
I think I might mail it to him in pennies.
Oh, yeah. What was that thing? Some guy
went into fortune. Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm saying, dude.
What?
That would cost you a lot of money, dude.
No, somebody just did that to the DMV.
With
wheelbarrows.
Yeah, dude.
Fuck yeah, dude. It's
fucking awesome. Can I take like actual ticket somewhere and pay it like at a place, or do I have to send it in through the mail?
I don't know, man. Read
I don't
the,
know. I mean, I can pay it online.
I mean, it's a government, so they're like they're like 10 years behind in technology. So
that's true.
You pay it online, but then they charge you the
well, they charge you a processing fee. Yeah.
Fuck. What the fuck?
Yeah.
God, I fucking. Dude, yeah. Just fucking mark.
It's literally called a convenience fee.
You should pay for it in pesos.
I wonder if I can pay for it in like $1 Starbucks coupons.
How fucking convenient. I can pay extra money to pay a bill.
Pay with it in pesos, dude.
what's the...
Do you guys accept Bitcoin?
Yeah. Yeah, dude. Fuck yeah. Dude, Bitcoin's up?
Either that or I'm going to send him a letter that just says you're... Some
you're
bitches
a,
or something
wiener.
Like that.
You're a wiener face.
Like, does anybody here have any Bitcoin?
Yeah.
You know what you should do? You should do it all, not only in Bitcoin, hell but yeah, do it in Satoshis. If you know what a Satoshi is, Satoshi is the smallest unit of money in Bitcoin. It's 1/100th of a cent.
Yeah, but it's not a physical thing.
So they don't have to like...
But I think it'd be funny to have somebody have to generate more fucking coding to give them more bullshit
yeah,
to have
but
to deal
like,
with. Fuck them.
Yeah.
Like, don't think. Yeah, you understand. how it works. All right, moving on. Trump war. Oh, we already talked about that.
No, what I was going to say.
Okay.
But did we do the Obama?
No, I mean, what I was going to say, I think during the fucking election, you know, hearing Trump speak and hearing Hillary speak, you know, Trump definitely sounded... more non-interventionist, and Hillary was not.
Yeah, but
total
he said a lot
hot.
Of shit that he's kind of said a lot of shit about Obamacare
said a lot of
and
shit.
Yeah,
and the wall.
He said a lot of shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Did you guys,
that's like no matter what he says, I don't trust.
Talk out of both sides of his mouth
like
all
the
time.
The first thing that comes to his fucking mind is just pow, it's out there.
Yeah, and like at this point, you know, you've also got his VP, who I've even heard some people say that he's going to basically handle the fucking domestic part of it. Yeah, you know, he sounds like a total fucking...
he's a delegator.
Yeah, he sounds like a total fucking warmonger.
Well, yeah.
He's a state.
So, yeah, Pence.
Pence is a statist piece of shit.
Yeah, dude. So, I don't know, man. Do you think Trump's going to be more violent than Barry or less?
Should we put a bet?
What did you guys talk about?
I doubt it's less.
Did you guys talk about Trump asking Congress for money for the wall now?
Oh yeah, the fucking yeah.
So first he
was saying, oh, go ahead.
Yeah. Well, he's basically saying Mexico's going to pay for the wall, and then he's like, oh, we'll see what Congress has to say about it. And, I mean, we all know how that's going to fucking go. It's not going to get paid for by Congress. You know, you fucking know damn well that Mexico is not going to pay for the fucking wall keeping them out.
Maybe he'll just...
And then Trump's just going to be like, nothing I can do.
I just wonder how many of these Congress...
To be a real president and go through Congress to make big decisions.
How many congressmen are really on board with the wall thing, though?
Probably, like...
I mean...
Yeah, no, I mean, I don't see how
it well, people are demanding
I only remember Trump ever talking about this, at least recently.
The wall?
Yeah, like I don't.
Since he's been elected, or
no? I'm just making the point. Like I have never heard this come up in Congress before.
The only wall we need.
And then
is
as soon
Floyd's.
As yeah, as soon as he started running, it was like
it was just like anything else.
We need to build. I mean, they've always talked about like stricter immigration reform, and you know the Mexicans are stealing our gerbs, but
they took our gerbs.
But
yeah, Hillary Clinton even talked about a fence at some point.
What's that?
Hillary Clinton even talked
she
about
did.
A fence in some point.
And Bill Clinton talked about a lot of the deportation. He actually deported quite a lot.
Well, didn't a lot of people actually get deported under Obama's administration?
Yeah, more than under Bush's.
Well, to be fair to Barry, they changed the rules on what count. But still.
Can we have a special...
Jared, I'd like to thank you for being fair to me.
Can we have a nice... Can we have a special live
clear.
Countdown to
doesn't mean I like your podcast.
Obama's last minutes in office?
Yo, did you guys...
Why would I listen to you?
Josh, I know you saw. You saw my status buddy get triggered by Alex.
Oh, it was hysterical.
The Biden meme.
The Biden, yeah.
Yeah.
Making fun of Joe Biden and his presidential...
Participation.
Yeah, it's a participation trophy. What the fuck did Joe Biden do? Other than tell people to what fire a rifle in the air, in which he said in the state of Delaware he could do, which it's funny because he's a lawyer there, which means he should know that you legally can't discharge a rifle in the middle of the air. It's a crime. He's an idiot. The man doesn't even know the laws in the state that he said he practiced law in.
Sounds like kind
it's
of a
retard.
Gotcha. Sounds like a little bit of a gotcha scenario. But...
He's a bit of a retard.
Okay.
Yeah, but I don't care for their politics. That dude's been through a lot, like over the past 8 years with his fucking.
I still like him though. What I like him better than any of them.
Fucking, what was it? His wife died, and one of his kids died, and then
no, his son died. His son was killed in Iraq.
Wait, so you like Joe Biden?
Just as a human being,
yeah. I like Joe Biden.
I like fucking Joe Biden.
I like Joe Biden as a meme.
I was gonna say I like him in meme form.
As a meme.
That's
Joe
really
Biden.
The
Joe,
like
Biden.
Joe
Biden. He's been through a lot.
Joe Biden memes are up. Invest. Invest in Biden memes.
His like you said, his son, one son died, and then his wife also died in like a plane accident or something, and two of his kids survived later. Just to go on, one of them died of like cancer or something back in 2015. So I mean, that's kind of fucked.
That does
deserve
suck.
A medal?
No. I'm not saying that. And I, like I said, I don't give a shit.
Man,
I don't care for his.
Has
politics.
The man been through a lot?
I
mean, yeah.
Obama's got a Nobel Peace Prize.
Yeah, well, he's a real.
Yeah.
Right.
Ooh. I don't know, but still, as a human being,
I definitely, I can't imagine having to go through something like that.
I don't
that.
Know. I definitely see them as the most. I don't know.
They're BFFs, man.
Yeah. It's you can kind of see that. That the office did take on quite a different tone.
Dude, have you seen like all the creepy Joe memes?
Oh, those are amazing, dude. Those are amazing. The creepy Uncle Joe, where he always does
that. It's where it's like him. Like they did one where it's like all the pictures of him being creepy. They cut out just him and
anime
like
chicks or whatever.
No. It was just him getting the medal and then him like kissing himself and like, dude, you know what I mean?
Oh,
like,
my God.
It was amazing. Fucking amazing. Yeah.
Oh, God. You see, he was crying. He had like tear in his eye. I mean, I can imagine you would be crying to get that award, but I don't understand. What did he get
He's
it for?
Actor. They can cry.
What did he get it for? What did he honestly do?
That was the other part
other than
of it. Is
it's making me laugh
bullshit, dude.
So
it's just
much.
Fucking, it's, they just gave it to him. It's like a, hey.
Well, dude, because it's exactly what they
dude,
said. It's a fucking participation
trophy. If being a politician
trophy.
Was like,
trophy.
If you're going to compare politics to fucking acting, Joe Biden is like the Steve Martin of the acting world of politics. You can't not like the guy. I don't care how much
you
of
definitely
fucking,
can.
Yeah. I mean, he's hysterical. It's just all the memes. Look what he's done. He's brought more joy to people's lives.
Yeah, but
fucking
he didn't
memes.
Do that. The fucking internet did that.
Think
yeah,
about that. He didn't Biden is the...
He's like the
Steve
fucking...
Steve Martin?
I'm going on based on the fucking hair at this point. I don't know.
Maybe. That's pretty good, actually.
You know what? Fuck him. Fuck the rest of the fucking...
I mean,
politicians.
I just, fuck Steve Martin. It how dare you?
Fuck Steve Martin.
It's just, how like, dare
I like,
you?
I like
it
Steve
makes
Martin.
Me cringe
I take that
when
back.
I when I see just like all this politician. Oh, here comes Stella.
Stella's gonna come join us.
All these like this politician
podcast pitbull
worshiping, where it's like, oh, it's so beautiful. Like, look at the relationship between Obama and Biden. It's like
you should look at the relationship.
Well, look
between...
at all the fucking dead people in the Middle East, right?
Exactly.
Now. You know.
Well, this
look
is
at ISIS.
Look what they did as a team.
Look what's going on.
They did it as a team, though.
Look, but to
Jared,
be honest,
teamwork
to be,
comes
to
first.
Be honest, think about it. Yeah. In an ideal world, if all the bombing and shit didn't exist, and all we saw was that relationship that they had, we would be like, you know, wow, that's a really
yeah. But my whole point is that
a lot of people have a lot of really good fucking relationships.
That's because in majority of people's worlds, what's going on in Syria doesn't fucking exist to them. It doesn't exist in their fucking world. They don't have to experience it.
They don't have to see it.
So all they
day.
See is how nice the president looks and how good how their lives are every single day. They're not. That's why. That's
they're
the
so
perfect
classy.
Scenario.
They're classy.
Yeah.
They're classy, man. Like that's what matters. Is are
He's
you classy?
Classy?
You could be. I mean, as long as you're classy, you can drop you, all the. You can fly all the drones you want,
dude. It's just this. This is.
You can imprison all the whistleblowers you ever to your heart's content as long as you are classy.
I really feel that the only goal of romanticizing the two of them as a couple is another attempt of trying to create the next like you know Jackie and John F. Kennedy.
Yeah,
that's all they're trying to do is to recreate like the new version
Wait,
of Camelot.
We're gonna make
guaranteed.
Another JFK.
It's already done.
What?
We're gonna make another JFK.
No, not like no.
Whoa, bro.
I'm saying
you are
the
banned from the podcast.
Holy shit, dude! No, I was not talking about that at all.
I'm just trying to clarify what
he's
trying to get across.
No, I'm talking no because before that there was a very romantic you know period in time for Americans that they had with you know John F. Kennedy and his relationship with Jackie. You know, Jacqueline Kennedy, and you know the fact they had a kid, you know John JFK Jr. that was in the White House. It became like the American family. So there was much more of a romanticizing of them, as you know the president and the first lady, you know, and the first family. So this is the next. When's the last time we had a full family? I think the Obamas are the first time since the Kennedys, really.
Well, what about? Oh no, I guess
since the Kennedys, I think really.
I guess
well, I
Bush's
mean,
kids
you
were
think,
older.
I mean,
think Hillary
what about Chelsea, dude?
Just, yeah,
you don't think,
say, what about...
You don't think Bill and Hillary were a power couple?
I mean, we
the
almost
the
had
Hilly
two
Billy
Clintons as president.
Fuck those two. But, dude, you have to admit, like, as far as being classier, the on TV, the way they were always portrayed,
everybody did
a good job.
Yeah, totally.
What about all the fucking people that want Michelle Obama to fucking run? As
hey, fuck those people.
Yeah,
that's what
should be a shoo-in.
Well, dude, I saw one. It was like shoo-in. All the Trump kids.
Oh,
yeah,
God.
It was like oh.
That's another thing. They said that while now that Trump is about to swear in, he's stepping down, kind of from. Well, not kind of. He's stepping down from all the. Business aspects of his life, and his two oldest sons are going to run the empire.
Yeah,
his empire.
About time for him to retire.
I question whether his kids are going to run it or not. Daddy's running the company still. Yeah. Come on, there's no flip. Make no fucking bones about who's running that goddamn company.
I can't believe there aren't like huge.
Yeah.
Well, no, I want to say I can't believe there's not huge
do
red
you,
flags.
Do you really
but
think
there's red
that
flags
I'm
going to
let
him.
These bozos run my company? You're making a huge mistake. It
just
be
a
quite
small loan
bigly
of
a decision to make.
Oh man, dude, have you seen those fucking? Have you seen on Conan where like he'll take these where he supposedly got these recordings of Trump calling Barry? And he's like, Bear, you know, he's like, you know, just ask, like, it's just Trump calling Obama and asking him, like, really stupid questions about, like, you know, what to do when he's president. It's fucking hilarious.
Was it Conan or was it
Conan does it.
If you haven't seen, I know the Dana Carvey's most recent stand up that he's done.
You talked about this before.
It was great. It's fucking great. He just talks about how shitty of the decisions that the Republicans and Democrats gave. But he's pounding the liberals though, man. He was just fucking going at
now,
him.
Did he come off as a libertarian or?
A libertarian
esque
like, leaning, yeah. But leaning a little drifting a little to more right. To the right. Yeah,
gotcha.
That would be a very good definition of that.
He doesn't look like, or he doesn't seem like he would though.
Well, he kind of dipped out of acting for a good while because his kids were growing up. Now his kids are out of the house, so now he's kind of getting back into it.
Back into it. That'd be nice, dude. I'd like to see him. I mean, it's only a fucking matter of time when they do a Wayne's World 3.
Oh, please, for God. Oh, do it. Please.
Really? Are you a big sequel person?
I don't care. I want another fucking Wayne's World.
Yeah, I mean, dude, who would not want to see another Wayne's World? You wouldn't?
No, I just wouldn't want to see them all, like, old and shit.
Exactly. They're not doing it to make another great film that, for people to enjoy. They're making it to a fucking exploit.
I mean, if it was well...
The title.
I don't know. If it was well done.
And they did the same thing with Star Wars. Granted, those movies were great.
Yeah, but I mean, like
Rogue One.
Dude, I'd rather
amazing.
See another Super Troopers.
Yeah, but like Mike Myers, for instance, like
they're making one.
It's fucking. I mean,
yeah, weren't they like?
They got crowdfunded.
All the fucking Austin
Wait,
Powers
that
movies.
Was a while
I thought
ago.
Were
what
funny.
Happened with that? Are they still working on it?
Yeah, no, they were. They started filming.
No refunds.
Over
Bernie
this
Sanders.
Past year, at some point, they were
for Super Troopers too.
They straight from, like their page, their themselves. Like what is it? Not what's their name?
Broken Lizard.
Yeah, straight from their Twitter or whatever. They had started filming. They posted pictures and everything.
Fuck
so
yeah.
God, that movie was fucking funny.
Yeah,
that's that. Now see, that's probably
to, what
in
about,
my top
what about,
10 comedies.
What about we? What about they had Beer Fest? What about Pot Fest?
Did not like Beer Fest.
Yeah, well, they were supposed to make a Pot Fest.
Yeah, what happened to Pot Fest? I want Pot Fest.
What'd you say? You did not like
you mean
Beer
there's
Fest?
Not a documentary
like,
called Pot Fest? There's got to be.
Beer
like,
Fest was
not a comedy.
But then
like
again,
that.
It's been a long time since I've seen it, so maybe
dude,
I have to go back and watch
dude,
it.
James Franco, Seth Rogen, to get all those fucking
dude,
guys
Beer
on
Fest
board with that.
Beer Fest is heavily underrated.
Beer Fest is a great fucking movie.
I didn't like it the last time I saw it. I only saw it once. I guess I got to go watch it again. I guess I was expecting another Super Troopers, and it definitely was not that.
It was the Super Troopers, but it was pretty fucking
I mean,
funny.
It's hard to live up to Super Troopers.
True. Agreed. All right.
Those guys are fucking funny, though.
Let's go.
Wayne's World 3. Make it happen.
I'm not even smoking weed.
Or don't.
Assange and Snowden for Chelsea Manning. Go.
Yeah. So, apparently Julian Assange this week offered to extradition if Barack Obama would pardon Chelsea Manning.
So basically what he said is, I'll give myself in.
Up.
Give in. Oh, don't worry. I'll give in.
There's not a difference, but okay.
Dude, I've been smoking the weed. I don't know. So anyways. So, yeah.
Did he say he would like stand trial and everything? Just if they give Chelsea Manning,
yeah, and you know, it's
wow,
kinda,
that would be
like it's pretty interesting. I wonder. I wish Obama would just acknowledge it. You know, he's doing all this fucking bullshit whining about how Russia hacked the fucking election. You know, and they use WikiLeaks to put all this fucking propaganda out.
Well, wait, no, hold on. WikiLeaks is fake news.
Yeah. Right. Okay. So. Yeah.
So was the fucking dossier they put out.
Yeah, WikiLeaks, who has what has it been over 10 years now, where they've, they've just put out like legitimate hacks. Like nobody's, they have a 100% track record for putting out the real fucking shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know. So yeah, I would like to see him acknowledge that he's acknowledge this. You know, see Barry acknowledge it.
Did sure. Snowden say he would do it too?
Yes. Well, Snowden basically said if you're only gonna offer.
Pardon.
Yeah, one pardon. Give it to Chelsea Manning.
Yeah.
But now, see, that brings me to my next question. I saw all this. I am uneducated on who Chelsea Manning is.
I'll explain.
Please do.
So explain, Josh Double.
Chelsea Manning is a transgender. Chelsea Manning was Bradley Manning, and Bradley Manning was, when he was in the Army, he leaked a document of a group of civilians and journalists that were in kind of like a caravan convoy together or whatever, and they were blown up.
Wasn't it a video?
It was on video. Yeah, it was on video.
Yeah, yeah.
Interesting.
And he, and what he did was he,
there was a machine gun one too.
He, they classified it. It was classified, and that was part of my job when I was in the Army, and I was a intelligence analyst. I also had to deal with the document classification. Certain documents you can't see at all. Like, the, you know, I mean, there are special ways to distribute them and carry them so nobody knows what's in them or that they're even a secret document to begin with. Mm-hmm. They were trying to make an attempt to bury this shit. They bury it, the problem goes away. And he said, all right, fuck it. Bloop. Dropped it on an open source. That's it.
And then
my unit was also
a terrorist.
My unit was also responsible for dealing with things like that. When Chelsea Manning was on trial, that trial was held in the building directly across the street from me, like from Matt's driveway to the driveway across. Like, that's how it was, in that building. And those documents have basically made him a criminal, treason. But the Army paid for the Army has agreed to pay for the surgery, you know, for Chelsea to undergo to make the transformation into a woman.
Huh.
Which is interesting. And then they're going to apparently try to kill her.
So, yeah, like executioner.
Even that logic on its own is a complete definition of how the military works.
Yeah.
They'll invest that money only to just kill you.
Could you eat? She's eating stuff down there.
So, do you think chances are of what's today? The 15th? Correct?
Yeah. Yes.
All right, so the chances of Obama pardoning Chelsea Snowden in the next 5 days.
Chelsea Snowden. Chelsea, they got married.
Chelsea Manning. What did I say?
Chelsea Snowden.
Fuck.
Are you high?
Ed, if you're Manning, perhaps Snowden, listening to this,
Snowden is Manning.
Actually, I remember my first beer.
Yeah, I remember my first beer. Somebody's a little drunk.
Finkel is Einhorn.
Yeah. Finkel? You want to? You want un Smirnoff Ice? Un Dussel Dussel.
I don't hear. This is payback for the man bun comment earlier before we started.
Oh. Is that what that is, dude?
Yeah.
Yo, you fucking peasant.
dude, maybe we should talk about this, dude. Where's the fucking man bun, dude?
I just don't have a man bun right now. My hair is down.
Everybody's wondering, dude.
No, everybody's not wondering. This isn't. Nobody gives a rat's ass about what my fucking hair looks like. Decided to fucking slick it back and put on a hat.
Oh, okay.
Be our own mascot. Yeah.
All right, so the chances of Obama pardoning Chelsea Manning are slim to none.
Slim to none.
I would say
slim
more
to none
on the
none
side.
President Trump. Will
slim to
do
none.
What do you think about Trump doing it?
You know what? I want to know where Black Lives Matter is.
No.
on Mumia Abu-Jamal.
Here's the whole thing. Okay.
What?
Here's the whole thing. When you think out the whole Assange thing, right? It, you know.
Pardon that dude.
You know, because you got to think, like, Obama probably wants Assange more than he wants Chelsea Manning.
That's my question. Is, do you think?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, because I mean, right now he's all hot about the quote unquote primary rigging. You know, which is bullshit. But so, you know, if Obama wants Assange more, and if Assange, you know, volunteers for extradition, then, you know, Assange is coming back during a Trump presidency where it's speculated that
Assange a U.S. citizen?
Right back.
No.
No, he's Aussie.
No, but I mean, like, they still want to fucking try.
But they want to try in America.
For yes. What supposed crimes against America?
I mean, like, it's probably illegal to leak documents, you know?
Yeah, but well, wouldn't he still be kind of tried
it's
under...
It's not illegal to leak documents. It's illegal to hack into the DNC and then leak documents.
Well, I mean, you know, honestly, I don't think we know about anything about WikiLeaks hacking into
shit. Well, I'm not saying
I think people pass over documents, too, though.
Right. But so, I'm saying if you're complicit,
Alex Jones,
if you're
he has all the documents.
I don't know. It's... Whatever. I'm sure they can come up with some kind of law, some kind of treason, or I guess it can't be treason because he's not American, but...
Yeah.
Whatever. Yeah, so, yeah, they obviously want him out of the picture more than probably...
Yeah.
So, I mean, Snowden, his damage has already been done to the state. he can't do anything more.
Yeah, but you know, like the whole theory is though, if Assange is over here, you know, it'd be under a Trump presidency, and Trump's got to like Assange a little bit, you know.
Yeah, for the shit that he, but no, he or, wants I mean, the he shit that he liked like about Hillary, yeah. Apparently.
Yeah, but I mean, he did help him out. I'm not saying it was his.
Well, I mean, Trump's got to have some respect for Assange, I would think.
I seriously doubt it because he's fucking out of his mind.
I mean, yeah, I don't know if Trump has respect for anybody really, but.
Trump's out of his fucking mind.
Look, he might not have respect, but he does have a "you pat my back, I pat your back" mentality.
Like you rub my cock.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Funny thing about
because I mean he's been like, and he got in trouble for this recently, but like, I forget who, some CEO helped him out, and so he tweeted buy this company's product or something. And so the White House had to like write up a memo to him saying like, yeah, you're not allowed to do that.
Don't do that.
Which is like, is that corporatism? Kind of, but...
Wait, there's no corporatism in the government?
Yeah, well...
I mean, I don't know. At the same time, like, something obvious like that, I wouldn't be as hard on it as... You know, okay, so for the president to... even the president yet, but the president-elect, right? At this point.
The president sack of shit.
To just give somebody an endorsement as opposed to, you know...
Making a
helping
law.
Helping them pass a law, exactly, yeah. A law, which is violence, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I mean, it's like obvious shit like that. I mean, it's the same thing. It's like, you know, is Fox News a little bit more respectful, more respectable just because they're obvious about their bias?
Well, you know what's funny? And I just thought of this. When you said that is
what's funny, Jared?
It's funny that you know, liberals are obviously going to attack Trump for this, yet and call it like corporatism or whatever or cronyism, but they forget the fact that Obama was part of passing the Monsanto Protection Act, which is also a large act of corporatism,
so. And greenlighting other pipelines to be built.
Yeah, among a million other things, but. Yeah.
I mean, well, the hypocrisy is endless, but that's just how the left is. I think the left does a better job at being hypocrites nowadays.
There's hypocrisy on the right, too.
Oh, absolutely, but I think they do a better job of it.
It's more apparent now, I think.
Yeah. They'll completely ignore their own hypocrisy. I mean, you know, case in point, Cory Booker and 13 other Democrats that voted against a bill that would allow... medication and pharmaceuticals coming from Canada into the United States at a heavily discounted price to the consumer.
Yeah.
They said no.
And these people receive a lot of money from Big Pharma.
And they're Democrats. Yeah. Well, Cory Booker got over $287,000 in the past 6 years from them.
Yeah. I mean, you know, to be fair, we should be just as hard on Republicans to do it.
Absolutely.
But, I mean, I think we should probably be harder on Democrats because those are the people that espouse against it. And they're being total
another,
fucking hypocrites.
Another layer of irony on that story is the fact that so Bernie comes out and he says like,
"Oh, this fucking guy."
Yeah, Bernie comes out and he's like, "You know, this is wrong. Like, we should be able to, you know, buy prescriptions and whatnot and medicines from other."
He was the one who was going after the FDA for that shit. He was the one who was arguing that why can't we get these drugs that are the exact same thing, but just Canadian. For a discounted price. Oh, well, we have to go inspect it. There has to be an agency made.
But hold on, the layer of hypocrisy is that's sort of a bastardization of a free market. You know, like a free market, you can go across borders. You can purchase from other countries or other states or other things, which is what, you know, someone like Rand Paul. By the way, did you hear about? So they repealed Obamacare basically at this point, but.
They didn't do it. They didn't repeal
they,
it.
They haven't done really
they've
anything
repealed,
yet.
They've repealed a few things of it. They repealed that they have to cover cover children up until the age of 18 or whatever. They got rid of that whole thing. And I think they got rid of the pre-existing conditions thing. And they're going to keep stripping it down. But they've been drafting a replacement, and I believe it was Rand Paul who wrote it. But basically, you know, what he wants to do is what we've sort of been arguing for a while, which is basically get rid of red tape and allow people to, you know, buy insurance across borders, you know, to go to another state and buy insurance if it's cheaper, which, you know, we all know will drive down
free market in it is what it needs. Yeah,
exactly. You know, which should drive down prices, assuming there isn't any other sort of regulations that pop up to hinder that. But
I don't have great confidence in the Republicans.
Oh no,
we're fixing.
No, yeah, I have no confidence in them
in
either.
Any free market kind
but,
of way.
I mean, Rand.
No,
Rand,
but I mean, if it is
I trust Rand,
I do trust Rand Paul to that degree.
I thought he had his own version of
Obamacare.
His own version of a rewrite.
Well, yeah, that's what
differ
I'm
than most of the Paul, it's going to differ
yeah.
from most of the Republicans.
Paul, I would think in a better way. You know,
yeah, yeah.
I mean, he's the fucking son of Ron Paul, who's like free market as fuck. You know, and in B,
what was that again?
And in B, he's also a doctor,
right?
You know, and I don't know. I mean,
he's
I think
a doctor.
It's pretty interesting to me to at least see what's going to happen as to whether or not I would endorse it 100%. I don't know. I mean, I'd have to see it. But, I mean, because healthcare was fucked.
I mean, I read it. It was...
Healthcare was fucked before Obamacare.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was.
I would think
getting rid of Obamacare.
I would think if anybody involved in the state right now could make it best, it would be Rand right. Paul.
I'd be all for him being involved in that.
Yeah,
exactly.
I read through it, and it seemed pretty legit. I mean, obviously, you know, the most legit would be just, like, get government out of there completely, but... You know, it was sort of like a slight compromise toward like a little bit of statism in healthcare, but
sure.
For the most part, it was, it was pretty free market. It was, you know, get rid of all the red tape, get rid of, you know, prohibition on interstate purchasing of insurance. And
some of the libertarian stuff I've read has made the medical savings account.
Oh yeah, that was another thing.
Sound pretty sweet, but
yeah, the HSA.
You have insurance. You have catastrophic insurance for car accidents and major surgeries and shit like that.
Yeah.
And then your payments go into a small interest bearing savings account that you spend at your will. So you get now you got choices.
Right.
I'm going to this doctor instead of this doctor because he's $100 cheaper.
Yeah.
Or whatever.
But apparently, the thing what they're trying to do is they're trying to disqualify things with pre-existing conditions.
That's not going to go away.
I thought they already did. I thought they already got rid of that.
I don't know. I don't really know. But
I mean, perhaps a replacement.
So
that's political suicide for Republicans. That'd be political.
So, question: like, okay, so if they've repealed it, is it now in 2016? Like, if I don't have health insurance, I won't get fined?
No, you'll still be fined.
No,
you'll still get fined.
You mean that's the part of Obamacare they're gonna forget about until last?
Well, no, I mean,
they're gonna steal fucking money from you.
Yeah.
They haven't gotten rid of it yet, but I, as I understand, I mean that's pretty high up on the. I mean that's the whole thing. Because if you get rid of that the whole system collapses, which was the idea.
Holy shit.
But I mean, I think what they want to do.
Jesus,
yeah. Dude, you're gonna fucking kill
killing motherfuckers over there.
You're gonna smoke
Sorry
them to
interrupt.
Death,
dude.
Fuck.
All right, guys. We gotta end this podcast.
Are you okay,
now.
Dude?
I'll survive.
Woo! Okay, we gotta end it or we can't talk about Stephen Harvey?
Oh, no, we can talk. I was just being facetious.
Okay, cool.
But I don't know what the Steve Harvey
is. Are you okay, Phil?
Regular weed. I just want regular weed.
Dude.
No thriller, no killer, no salmonella.
So, so what's this about, like, Steve Harvey, dude?
So, basically, President Obama and... President-elect Donald Trump decided that they were going to call up Steve Harvey to get, you know, to speak with them. And they're suggesting that he help Ben Carson, who is going to be the head of housing and urban development. That's basically why he was called, because they want him to get involved.
But, like, why Steve Harvey?
My first assumption is that because Steve Harvey being the... I used to watch Steve Harvey show back in the day.
He's funny as fuck.
That's good for you, man.
Steve Harvey show was fucking awesome, dude.
But it was. I thought it was pretty fucking
funny. I thought it was awesome, yeah.
He's also a bit of a religious nut job, but...
Yeah.
But I'm just saying the television show was fucking
no,
funny.
No, yeah,
dude.
I watched it like every night
but
before I went to bed.
I really think that he's going to... he's picked because of, you know, being on Family Feud? Is that the fucking show he's on?
Yeah.
Family Feud. He has to deal with hearing white people say crazy shit all the time on that show.
I mean, but here's the thing. That show's
I
not
think that's
real.
Why they
like,
picked
it's,
him,
it's,
though. No. I, real or not, man, those reactions are the reactions I literally have inside when I hear people
say
dumb shit.
I'm sure he has some other sort of
qualification. Even the dumb shit they say is fake.
I know, but I think the fact that this man also knows how to deal with dumb people around him at all times.
The dumb shit they say is fake.
That's why they're putting him with Donald Trump, because he can handle the dumb.
They bring him on and give him the dumb shit to say.
That's why they put me with you, dude.
Yeah, it's not real.
Heyo. Yo, did you? There was some quote that came out from Ben Carson where he was basically like, "I don't want to benefit any American more than another American."
What?
Like basically, he doesn't want to engage in the whole welfare system as it regards the, you know, the urban development shit.
That's a welfare agency.
I know.
Oh no! They say, what's the best thing? Well, what's the best way to get people off of government assistance? No, what's the best way to help people on government assistance is to get them off of it.
Yeah, yeah. He said that too.
Yeah, he said that.
The best way to do that,
dude.
Is
but
just
see, yeah, it's another example of like Trump.
But most people are going to see all the Republicans' answer to get people off. It's just to, you know, pull the care altogether and, you know, pull the rug out from under them, rather than, you know, try to find ways to actually get people off fucking government assistance. That's what the assumption's immediately going to be.
Yeah, but I'm looking at it like, dude, it seems like a lot of these cabinet picks are all like the antithesis of their positions, which
yeah,
I think is awesome.
Yeah, hell yeah, dude.
I am worried, and I've said this before, but I am worried about Sessions just because he's very anti-drug, and that scares me a shitload.
Yeah, dude.
But aside from that, I'm not that concerned. Oh, they also did a point like, what is his name? The RFK Jr. The anti-vaxxer guy as like on some committee for like vaccination. I don't know, some sort of scientific committee.
I did see that,
which is pretty scary. But
hey, Jared, I'm just curious. Yeah. Are you going to Porkfest this year, dude?
I don't know. I can't say that on the podcast.
Why?
Because I don't want to commit. I don't want you to be able to like play
that?
Back.
Dude, you should kind of commit, dude.
A podcast of me committing.
Dude, everybody's listening, dude. Everybody wants to know, dude. Is baby
nobody,
Captain Gerbil's going to go,
still
dude?
Early.
Everybody
they
wants to know if you're
going. When is it? They're going
to
have.
Everybody wants to know if you're
it.
Going, so they can choose to not go.
What?
They'd like the warning ahead of time.
Hey, Jared.
Do you think they've hit their Jew quota yet?
Dude, I'm saying, dude, right now you can probably get tickets for like $10, dude, because like the fucking you get like or like $25 or something, like or. Like earlier in the year, the tickets are much cheaper, dude. Like Jew light bulb, you know, like right there. Like,
but isn't that in like that's in like September, isn't it?
No, Logan, it's in June.
Yeah, I gotta see what I'm doing as far as
I can't
vacation.
I probably can't go to that
festival sorts.
Why you got plans that day?
No, man, I'm just
I can't afford that day.
when is Pork Fest?
No, I can't afford
it's
to
fucking,
take any time off of school.
Oh. Should we mid-June. Tell the listeners what Pork Fest is?
Sure, go ahead, dude.
Shouldn't they already fucking know?
Pork Fest is a festival, a libertarian anarchist festival held every year in, is it Manchester, New Hampshire?
I believe it's an hour from Manchester.
An hour from Manchester. Oh, I'm thinking of Bonner. That's
it's
in
like,
Manchester, Tennessee.
It's like very like the north part of New Hampshire, isn't it?
On Rogers Campground.
Yeah, Rogers Campground.
Just fucking no cops, no authorities.
Yeah, that shit's legit.
Yeah. I mean, it's basically...
It's basically anarchists in the woods. It's a thousand anarchists camping, and you just like fucking do whatever you want. You talk philosophy. You
do some drugs.
Conceal carry.
Really?
You know, yeah.
I didn't know that.
Well, no, actually, not concealed carry, open carry.
Open carry.
Okay. There's probably people concealing, too, though.
Oh, there was definitely people concealing.
I mean, there's fucking people concealing.
I saw
Baltimore
people
just
lift up their shirt with
you were
the
like,
fucking...
You were like, hey, is that a gun in your pants? And they were like, yes.
Like,
I
was
like,
I'm disappointed.
It's
a gun in my pants.
Yeah, why do they have to sound like that?
Yeah, yeah, I mean, I'd say it's the most wonderful time of the year. So, Jared, dude, are you going to
Wow, I hope they don't do fucking karaoke because those people aren't prepared for that assault on their fucking ears.
Wow,
you're going to give them. Jesus Christ.
Dude. Okay, so I guess you're not going to go either, Josh.
No.
He already told you. He's busy that day.
Okay.
He's got a hot date.
Josh has a furry
with
furry
his cousin.
Yeah, but is Logan going to go?
Oh, that's when the My Little Pony convention is. That's what you were going
to. You're a brony?
I don't know, dude. I'd be very interested in going. I would maybe I'll take my vacation around that time and I'll
the brony conference. Yeah,
it's fucking awesome. I would definitely
do you like drive up like
or... I flew back with a brony.
Yeah, we drive up, dude. Well, I drive up because Bergman doesn't drive.
Oh, do you hear that? You hear this, Matt? He had experience with brony.
You don't have wait.
The brony drive?
I ignored him.
He's just
I flew back.
He doesn't like
not a big driver.
He's not a
with a brony.
Yeah.
Not a driving guy.
Yeah, man.
Was he a British brony?
I might be interested in going.
Oh, he was a British brony.
Dude, we get a sweet spot.
Are there like so? Wait, again. It's in the woods.
Was
or?
His name Tony?
Well, yeah, and then like
and it's like everybody's
Tony
in like
Tony Baloney.
Yeah, and then like
Tim well, campers.
Yeah, and are you familiar with Tim Davis?
No.
Yeah.
How do you know Tim Davis?
Okay. I mean, Tim was on the podcast, right?
Yeah. Was he? Did he ever?
What?
Wait, did he come down and visit one time after Porkfest?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, he's definitely
Okay.
I mean, he's been in Baltimore and we've like hung out and shit, and we're definitely going to have him on the podcast again. Yeah. So basically, you know, Tim Davis will be there, man. He's fucking awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. I'd definitely be interested in going, especially. I got a sweet hammock tent. I mean, it's like a tent, but it's a hammock.
Okay.
Okay. All this right. Podcast has gone off the rails.
Yeah.
It's a hint.
So I guess that's
free
it for
range
tonight.
Free range podcast.
It's a tent.
So that's it for tonight. And until next time, live free
or die.
Non-aggression principle, the violence in the state becomes obsolete.